Good morning, Angie Dickinson.
Good morning.
Angie, how are you today?
Oh, I'm all right.
Just all right?
Yes.
Oh. Well, I'm frankly feeling terrific.
Oh, I'm feeling terrific.
Oh. Well, that's nice to know. I ate a lot of asparagus last night, by the way. I think you ought to know that. I understand that's very good for one's libido.
It appears to be.
Uh-huh. Are you ready for the big love scene?
Oh, yes. I just woke up, so I feel in the mood. I hope I'm not... don't seem interested, but I'm just tired. You know how those nights are.
Oh, I understand. Yes, I've had a few of those nights myself. Okay. Here goes the big love scene.
And now take six of On Lame Duck Pond, the love scene. We join our overheated pair in the Fanny Fox suite of the Wilbur Mills Hotel on Rita Jenrette Drive.
Excuse me. Pardon me, Frank, dearest. Who is that?
Well, that's our announcer, and he's our script writer, Mike Clary. He's the one that has you playing the part of Dawn Fall, and I am Adman Gesundheit, the arms dealer.
Oh, darling, you know me well enough to know I am not a temperamental Hollywood star. I ask for little in the way of creature comforts. Still, I have grown accustomed to champagne and flowers in the dressing room with my own makeup specialist. I did agree to forego even those niceties for the pleasure of playing opposite you.
Well, what can we do to make you happy?
I am happy. I'm happy. But I'm happy being here with you. It's just that I have a commitment to creative excellence. If you're going to do a love scene with me, I must insist on a closed set. Tell your associate to go away.
But you see, Angie, he's the keeper of the words. He's provided the script which will inspire us to new heights.
I've seen the script, Frank. Rip it up.
Wait a minute.
You and I shall take our own feelings from one another onto the set and let that inspire us. Words of love will flow from us.
You know you're right. Hey, Mike, here.
Aww.
Would you take this and leave us alone, okay? Okay. Angie and I'll create a new Dawn Fall and a new Adman Gesundheit. All right, Angie, we are finally alone.
Oh, begin, my dear, and be gentle. Let the spark of love dance about before growing into a torch of passion and desire.
Oh, Dawn.
Call me Angie, Adam.
Call me Frank Angie.
Oh, Frank. Five little letters that spell fabulously romantic and naughtily kinky.
Angie. Five little letters that spell adult niceties grow in earnest.
You better than that.
Yes. Adult niceties grow in earnest.
They do, don't they?
Oh, Angie.
Oh, you jumped a
page. How about adoringly nice, gorgeous, interesting, and exciting?
No, not a complete sentence and too many words.
Oh, Angie, what are we doing? We're taking precious moments to bounce our knubbers at one another. Come here, my blonde bombshell. Let me embrace you.
And let me answer back with fluttering kisses designed to be mere appetizers to the feast that follows.
I knew it would be like this.
It's everything I dreamed of.
They were right. They were right after all.
Right, my romantic warrior. Right about what?
It is better than golf.
Love is a many splendid thing. It's the April rose, the earth is nature's way of giving. Reason to be living, the golden crown that makes a man a king.
Well, what can I say? What can I say?
Oh, you gave it your best shot.
Oh, yes. That was wonderful. That was wonderful. Angie, are you all right?
Well, yes. I am. Are you?
I think so.
I'm a little horny, but other than that...
I've canceled my tea time for tomorrow.
that was my tea time.
Oh, it was.
I loved it. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Listen, that was so much fun.
I was there, and I almost came in to do it with you.
I know
but
you.
I don't think we could have managed.
No, I think it was much better that we did this sort of through the courtesy of AT&T.
Can I come back in the room now?
You can come back now, Mike.
Oh, Mike, are you still there?
Yeah, he's still here.
Oh, well, leave.
Well, Angie, you know, I actually do know that you almost made that appearance with us live in the studio, but I think you're right. I don't think we could have handled it looking at each other.
Oh, and Mike, you know, you're right, but I really would love to talk to Mike once in a while, but I just don't think it's worth the risk.
No. Time is so precious between us. It's a shame to waste it on me. Angie, well, now you go about your business today with a warm spot in your heart.
Oh, yes.
Yes. And have a nice day down there.
And, oh, yes. Okay. Bye, friend.
Goodbye, Angie.